point is that you distribute $150 billion to all the states on a per capita basis. Yeah. You are assuming that that increase in demand that you stimulate with that money
with the payroll tax holiday,
private sector jobs?
With the payroll. The reason we lost private sector jobs is one reason. It's because sales fell off.
Okay, but you've got to admit that the deficit simply explodes at that point.
The deficit gets larger, yes.
It explodes.
And you understand what the deficit is from your school days, right?
Well, look, that's all theoretical stuff.
No, this is operational fact. I'm not talking any theory or philosophy here.
Go on.
Okay. When the government spends, it adds balances to reserve accounts at the Fed. These are checking accounts at the Fed. Okay. And when the government taxes, it subtracts money from checking accounts at the Fed. Net spending, deficit spending, is a net add of dollar net financial assets to the system. It's an accounting identity that the government deficit equals sector savings.
So we print
non-government savings.
We print it.
Printing is a word that goes back to the gold standard. It's the ratio between printed money and the gold supply. It's not an applicable term.
Warren,
the applicable term is weak.
Smart and intellectual and theoretical.
This is a fundamental error that's been made and why we're in the situation we're in now.
Okay.
When you have a non-convertible currency and a floating exchange rate, all government spending is merely changing numbers in bank accounts. The person at the Treasury who changes numbers up, and he's the spending is operationally independent from the taxing.
Okay.
There's no operational constraint.
I got to go because I'm out of time and my head's spinning.
And I've been under oath, by the way.
Oh, really?
Yes.
But not on this program.
On this program.
Warren Mosler, that was interesting, and we appreciate you being with us, Warren.
Thank you very much.